What is happening, everyone? My name is Phil with Think Make Do, and we are filming today from my new mobile construction trailer. Isn't that cool? This is a 6x10, I think, some kind of look something trailer. I got it off some guy on Facebook Marketplace. This started as a $3,000 piece of crap trailer with a ton of problems. The lights didn't work, the floor was falling apart, all the wood was moldy and just disgusting. The roof has some cracks in it, it was leaking, there's puncture marks all over the place, panels that were not, you know, quite screwed down, and I fixed almost everything to get it into the condition that you see it now. So let's go over just a couple things, starting with the floor. So if you'll notice, I have replaced all the floors here. These are now 3/4 plywood. I think it used to be OSB. The 3/4 plywood, I actually painted with a truck bed liner on both the top and the bottom, right? So a lot of trailers, you might protect the inside floor facing the inside, but on the outside, on the bottom, you know, you're driving around in different conditions and the weather damage just destroys it from the bottom. So I painted the bottom, I painted the top, I also painted the rails to prevent rust, and now this is in really good condition. I've added all these D-hook rings everywhere so that I can tow whatever I need to tow. And this is actually premium plywood, not premium, just like regular plywood, so it's much better than OSB. Anyway, that's the flooring system. Now, when you look to my sides, I have a couple different drawers and chests, right? And everything is modular. So, well, this one I'm missing wheels, but it will become rolling. But all these cabinets here, these are all rolling cabinets. And that means I can move these out or reposition them when I'm moving this trailer around for better weight balance. This is a very heavy drawer with a lot of utilities and tools and stuff in it. And if I don't like the weight balance, I can swing this out, bring it into the center, strap it down, and make sure that when I'm driving, I have the right weight or the weight balance or counterbalance, as well as having the right amount of weight over the axle, which is right here. The other cool thing I did with this trailer is I replaced all the sides and foam insulated. So I have about an inch of foam on each side. The bottom sections here, coming up to about 40 inches, is half inch plywood. And that's because I just need a solid surface to put things against, right? The top section here, this last kind of 30 inches, I've used 3/4 plywood and I've drilled it directly into the steel rails going up the sides. And that gives me a really strong point to mount stuff to or to hang stuff from. And that's why I've added all the French cleats so that I can bring in a lot of my tools that are French cleat system in my workshop and just bring them in here. Now I am screwing them down, so this is super secure, it's not going anywhere. But at least the French cleats allow me to decide where things go and I don't have to think too much about, oh, do I have to remount it here? Do I gotta remount it there? I can slide it along the French cleat, take stuff from over there, bring it over here and vice versa. So that is the whole wall system. Now, what you can also see is the lighting system. So these are under cabinet lights that go in some of my more premium closet builds, right? And I had extra material and I figured why not use it here. This is good soft lighting, but it's also strong. It has like 4,000 Kelvin, so it is kind of like more daylight white. And I'm gonna be working on, maybe not furniture in here, but you know, parts of a home renovation. And so I figured good lighting will make me feel good. These tracks are really nice, they're super sleek, so I'll like them. And it'll make me want to work in here. So that's why I put these in here. It's a 12 volt system, and that means I need 12 volt power, and I have everything wired up on a light switch here on a 12 volt switch. Now, this is also a three-way switch. So I can go over here, turn this off, come all the way over here where I have the other switch, turn it back on. And there is a second light switch for exterior lighting sources. So this second switch right now is not connected to anything. However, when when I want to, I'm going to install some floodlights on the outside, one outside this door and probably two in the back, and each one of these lights is going to control the exterior lighting as well. So this is a 12 volt light source. Right now I have this battery thing, this power supply powering everything, but it's just going to convert to a 120 volt to 12 volt LED driver. I'm going to mount here on this kind of electrical wall, and that's how it's going to be powered long term. Now, where am I getting all the power? I am getting it, if you go all the way down here, from this main source, which, if you can see, it is a shore power plug connected to a regular extension line. And so I can hook in, I think it's pretty common among trailers to do that, but I can now hook in on the job site wherever I'm at and have power. I also have a master kill switch here, so I can leave that powered in and then I can just make sure everything is turned off. Now, everything is powered to that. So I have a four gang, I don't know what you call it, four outlet, another four outlet, another four outlet, another outlet here. And so my battery chargers at the moment are right here. Now I'm gonna add more battery chargers. I'm not like super into having a ton of batteries, right? I can't afford that many. But what I do think is cool is on my drill thingy, all the batteries are right in the back. And so I would say I've never actually seen that before. So I don't know, this might be a cool design other people follow, but all the batteries get stowed back here, right? They fit right between this 3.5-inch space and tools go back in here, right? So now these will fit the 20 volt or like the really large DeWalt batteries. I did make the right cutouts for it. So those are the smaller cell DeWalts, but the largest cell as well as that Fat Max one that you put on circular saws, that'll fit in here as well. What else can I show you about this trailer? Oh yeah. So this miter saw station, you know, I don't have like a rolling cart for a miter saw. So this is kind of what I came up with. Because it's inside, everything is 36 inch tall, right? So I can put really long material on here and make my cuts. Now I also have made this a extension. I don't quite yet have the stabilizer here set up, but as soon as that's ready, I'll have a super long table all the way across that I can cut from. Now I also have a vacuum system down here. So this is not complete yet, but I have a dust cyclone. It will connect to any shop vac at the top here. I'm probably gonna put it in here. And I have a vacuum switch in here as well. So anytime this tool turns on, the vacuum will turn on and the hope is all the dust will suck down into there and not cause me to cough incessantly while I'm inside this dusty ash trailer, right? So that's the plan. yeah. So not everything is done. These drawers, this was my first try making these like routered drawer slide thing, and I'm waiting on some handles to come in, but I'd say it works pretty well. I got wood screws, other screws, tools, random supplies, some other random supplies, and some tools down there. I did try to router out this hole, but I don't have the right bit. So it was kind of messy, so I stopped doing that. So these two router holes are the only ones you'll see, this one and this, and I'm gonna move to handles for the rest of them. But it's a lot of organizing, and I think that'll be really good. Now, this is where I keep all of my, you know, my pneumatic guns or whatever other kind of guns. They're just larger tools, right? Probably a tool chest is gonna go in here. And in here is probably gonna go a bunch of shelves for, I don't know, more stuff like this to fit in there. Yeah, this is just like my first tool cart, right? This Husky thing that I took to Hawaii with me to work on a condo there a number of years ago, and it's held up well. So you can't really just like throw it away, even though I wanna get something else, but this is probably gonna be around for a while. I've got all these U-line storage totes, and these are like all door hardware, right? Like fence wire thingies. And then I have all these bins here with all these different supplies. So I try to make it so I have all these random plumbing supplies that I stick in here, right? Putty, pipes, whatever. And yeah, I have enough space for 6 bins in this back or in this front section. That's a lot of storage for me. That's gonna be pretty good. The last thing I would care to mention, I don't know. I think that might be it. Anyway, just wanted to share what I've been working on. This entire thing is on wheels, right? So all these shelves are on wheels, which means everything is mobile, which means everything can come out of this trailer. So, I mean, wishful thinking, right? On a nice day, I should be able to wheel all this stuff out and work on it from, the driveway or wherever I'm at. But the real reason I put everything on wheels is because I don't have a large truck bed to haul stuff. So this cargo trailer is also gonna be a stuff hauler. And so on certain days when I need to get a lot of materials or get like appliances, large stoves, washing machines, dishwashers, you know, like things that just really wouldn't fit in my SUV or would be hard to load into my SUV, I am going to either reconfigure this stuff to move out the way or move it all out and then pretty much empty the trailer and make it available as a cargo trailer. And for me, because of my particular situation, that's what's most useful and practical in this space. Now, not everyone's gonna need that, but I do think it's nice to have everything on wheels anyway. If I ever upgrade trailers or I move into a garage, I can just take the wheels and wheel this stuff out of here and make more space. And for me, that mobility is super important and really exciting, essentially. Now, I built this trailer because I need to, not because I want to. My next project and my next video series is going to be a residential renovation job that I don't think I revealed yet to anyone, but is a triplex in Los Angeles that I'll be working on, and there is no garage. There's nowhere for me to work. So in the past, I've always taken over a garage space and had place to just put everything. On this property, I don't. And so this tool trailer is going to be my mobile work site for the next 6 months, and that's why I built it. Do I plan to keep it long term? Probably. This is pretty cool. I like being in here. Despite the fact that it's barely 6 feet tall and I kind of, I'm touching, you can't really see, but my head kind of grazes the top. I've already hit my head a bunch of times getting in and out of here, but but yeah, maybe I should have gotten a 7x12, but at that point, I may or may not fit into tight spaces or be able to make tight turns, and I'm not like a super experienced cargo hauler, so the smaller is probably more manageable for me, at least that's what I think right now. Anyway, that's all I've got for you guys today. I hope you like this kind of tour. I'd say this trailer is about 80% complete, but I have to get to the job site, so it doesn't matter if it's done. I gotta take it with me. Anyway, thank you. I'll catch you guys later. I'll catch you on the next one.